My name is Aurora, and I've been dancing and performing since I knew how to walk in my mother's high heels. I'm an artist, an actress, and I just happen to be transgender. I've been in the spotlight almost my entire life, and a few months ago, I decided to enter a pageant called Miss Gay USofA, and I won. Join me on my travels as I explore the best of LGBTQ America. I don't want to break it.
This time, 2 weeks.
Are you on the run?
No. I heard that.
I have to hide.
Nancy's hiding.
I'm hiding from immigration.
She's hiding from. She's hiding from Donald Trump.
Someone's carrying a couch down the side of the road. Only a little rock.
But first of all, thank you all of you for coming to the prelim and believing in us. We're fighting hard to get Miss back, and I am going to charge whoever wins both of these categories or both of these divisions tonight to get me contestants.
I remember 20 girls. Her year she won, there was 22. The year I competed, it was 18.
Okay. I'll be happy with getting me back to 7, 8, 9, 10. Hell, 5.
Hey, how y'all doing? My name is Eartha Iman, Boom Boom, Fat Cow Quake, Abby the Facebook. I said can take names. How you doing?
Winner.
Chicken dinner.
The club I'm at tonight is part of a larger complex called Discovery here in Little Rock, and it is the original home of another national pageant called Miss Gay America.
Miss Gay America 2017 is no other than contestant number.
My heart's racing.
Ready? One, Susie Long.
America is the only national contest where you have to be 100% boy. You cannot be transgender. You cannot have any body work from the neck down. A lot of people have asked, you know, how do you work as a drag entertainer if you're transgender? You can be transgender and do drag, but, you know, but most transgender people don't do drag or would not ever consider themselves drag queens or want to be referred to as drag queens. Trans queens and boy queens have performed together for years. And actually, for the first time ever this season, RuPaul has put a trans queen on the show. Yes, this is how I live my life. I live my life as a woman. But at the end of the day, as long as I'm happy and I'm not hurting anybody, then what does it matter?
Hey, how are you?
Good.
Hi, I'm Leah. I'm contestant number one in the Miss Division.
Gorgeous. Good luck.
Thank you.
I'm contestant number two, Veronica Duvall, competing for Miss Arkansas USofA.
Just oh, you're the dress room attendant?
Yeah.
Your security? So if they storm me, are you going to protect me?
Definitely.
Okay. Nice to meet you.
You look fabulous.
You look handsome.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ambrosia Bordeaux, Miss Gay Arkansas America 2014. And the MC tonight.
Thank you.
I'm better naked.
Aurora, why do you look so pretty all the time?
I'm just blessed.
Because you're just awesome like her. Mm-hmm. Awesome. It's because we're a beautiful family. Mwah. Love you.
Love you.
Everyone's an entertainer in their own right, but everybody just has their own avenue in which they express themselves. And I mean, there's many different aspects within the LGBTQ community, and we just happen to be one of those aspects, but we decided, or we felt that we were born to live our lives a different way, but we still love the art of performing. So even though that we may not, you know, fit in that norm of what people consider to be drag, we're still entertainers at the end of the day. Going to USofA, it just opens the doors for so many different avenues to express yourself. So it was a very life-changing experience.
Contestant number one, Leah Alizé. So ladies, if you'll just take a couple steps forward for me, two steps please.
Just give it all you have. Don't hold anything back, because when you hold back, that's when you have regrets when the contest is over. So whatever the results are gonna be, just make sure you did all that you could, so then that you have no regrets when it's over.
Our evening gown winner for the night.
Come on, Leah.
For this. That would be Laura Alze.
Yeah!
Leah Alze.
Come on, Tina!
Our interview winner for this evening.
Come on, Leah.
I wouldn't want to be a judge for this one. That goes to Veronica Duvall. Yeah! We're just going to go ahead and crown our first alternate. It is Leah Alizé. Come on, you guys. You saw the blood, sweat, and tears she put out there. Make some fucking noise! And our newly crowned Miss Arkansas USofA 2017, Veronica
Noel! Okay, wait a second.
I'm so used to having my title and it ain't funny. All right, Joseph, can I ask the crowd my number for Miss Veronica?
So after crowning, I went backstage to talk to the runner-ups like I always do, and not everyone was happy with the results. I walked up to this girl and she took her flower bouquet and just started hitting everything. I mean, flowers and leaves and petals going everywhere. It was crazy. She took her plaques and threw them in the garbage. She was screaming, and She was very upset.
We're here.
I'm always trying to love her as a sister. And I would never, ever deal with no one from Arkansas.
I've lost pageants before. I've lost way more than I've won. And yes, it's disappointing, and at times it's upsetting, but I never acted that way. I can look back at those times and say, no, you shouldn't have won. And I think it's important to learn from your mistakes and grow as an entertainer, as a person. It's unfortunate that she chose to act that way. And as a result of her actions, she's no longer allowed to compete for Miss Gay USofA, which I think is a shame because she's very talented and I thought she was very good. A lot of times it really comes down to interview. And if you have a bad interview or if you put such a bad taste in the judges' mouths from the get-go, it's really hard to fix that. You know, it's like that old saying goes, you only get one chance to make a good first impression. So don't f*** it up.
From day one, I wanted to be Miss Gay America, and I was feeding it into my head. And it happened, but it wasn't without crossing my T's and dotting my I's and coming in prepared. And I'm very proud of myself for being organized and for planning and strategizing and having people around me that are honest. You too, Aurora, being honest. You're like, honey, if you're gonna do this, come in to slay and be creative and be you. And so I feel accomplished in that. I was nothing less of being myself. So I'm proud. I feel very proud.
Now that you've won, what are you gonna do now?
I'm gonna go eat some fried chicken.
There are several other national pageants like Miss Gay USofA in the United States, and for the first time ever, all of the national representatives, including myself, are getting together for a photo to spread unity and peace.
So you look really like, I just want a prom date. So, you better smile differently.
Girl, you know what? Okay.
You know, I never could have imagined all the doors that being Miss Gay USofA would open for me. All the amazing experiences that I would have, the people I would meet. It's honestly been one of the most magical years of my life. And I wouldn't trade this experience for anything.